we mean it. With you. You know, if you've ever taken voice lessons or been in a choir even, a lot of times our directors, our well-meaning directors and coaches, I'm turning this way because I want you to see, over here you see my guitar in the background, and then you see my keyboard over here, and I've mentioned they just look really great in my room, and I tried to take guitar lessons, I'm terrible at it. Piano, I'm getting a little bit better every single day as I try and use it. Now, we're sometimes made to feel as singers as though our voice is like a guitar, meaning that, now I don't know if you've ever picked up a guitar, but here's what I know about guitar. Every single time you pick up a guitar, you have to check to see if it's in tune. You cannot just jump on it and play. I mean, you might start playing and then, oh, hold on, and then you got to tweak it a little bit. And some people who have great ears can tweak it even without using any kind of device. Now, the keyboard is very different because, see, now with a guitar, I have to make sure that I know the exact right. I mean, it's not just about knowing where to place my hand on the fret. I have to know exactly the right amount of pressure, and this is what I just could not master, the right amount of pressure in order to be able to get one note. I could strum it and it's going to make a pretty sound. But if someone says play an E, I have to have the right amount of pressure or it's just going to sound like a big old thump or a thud. Okay. But now with my keyboard over here, and I want you to imagine this is a piano, with my keyboard over here, no matter what note I play, it's going to play that note. No matter how much pressure I put on the key, it's going to play that note. Okay, without any skill on my part, whatever I touch on the piano, that's what it's gonna play. That's how your larynx is. Your larynx is your instrument that God designed and He gave each one of us, and your larynx knows how to play. Now, here's what I want you to know that I mentioned earlier about our voice coaches and our choir directors, well, everyone well-meaning, but a lot of times they make us feel like we have to warm up like this guitar over here. We have to make sure that it's in tune, okay? But really, your voice is much more like a piano. Okay, it doesn't necessarily need to be warmed up. Now, yes, I will say once you hit a certain age, it might. But here's why I'm saying that. Let's say you have a big show. More than likely, you're not going to begin that show with your biggest song in the show. You're going to start out with something mild, kind of introduce you. You want to warm up the audience, and that song is going to warm up your voice. I also would imagine that you have not been silent the entire day leading up to that song, okay? Now, what's the one exception here that some of you might even be thinking of if you sing in choir? Well, at 8 o'clock in the morning, we show up and we go ahead and it might be we haven't really done a lot of speaking. But even then, you're gonna run songs. My point is you can run the songs, but you don't need to go out of your way. Never panic, never question yourself. Don't worry, don't be concerned if you have not had time to do a separate vocal warm-up. And it doesn't take long. Let's say your song is a big. Sometimes I get a power ballad whenever I'm doing a solo with my church. It is kind of a big song, and I want to make sure that I can hit it. So I am going to just wake up my voice. And so those are the exceptions, I would say, to the rule. But never panic if you haven't really had time to warm up your voice. You just have to trust it. It's really more so your mind. You have to really get your mind just at that place. And you have to know that if you've put your time in, you've practiced the song, you've learned the song, that the song is going to be great. Just go out there and give it your all. Remember that very first session, I said that there is no thinking and singing, there's only hearing and feeling. And I've talked about that hearing part, but remember that feeling part is just go out and show us how you feel about that song. That's going to take you way farther. It's going to cover a whole lot. In fact, you can even have errors, slight errors in your performance. But when you are delivering it from your emotions, it doesn't sound like an error. It sounds like a vulnerable moment to the audience, and we're open to it. And we actually appreciate being allowed to see into that vulnerability that you have during your performance. So it can actually work in your favor. You know, when Christina Aguilera recorded Beautiful, she was gonna race it. Just go ahead and run through the whole thing nonstop. And she did that. And from what I understand, maybe it's an urban legend, but from what I understand, she wanted to go back and start recording. And they said, nope, that's it. We're going to keep the whole thing. And they kept it the way that it was. And she wasn't happy about it. And yet the one that you hear, if the urban legend is true, that it was her first run through of just showing them her ideas and what she was planning on doing with it. And they kept it as is. May not be true. I don't know. But I like to think that it's true. I think that if anybody could pull that off, it is Christina Aguilera.
And we sing it like we're married.